Mostly Photo, all one word, or go to mostlyphotoadventures.com and click the Winners tab. Now, we're going to do it again this week. Each winner gets a $100 gift certificate to Amazon. Let me see. I have it right here. I want to make sure I say it right. To Amazon.com. And there are two winners. You get a People's Choice Award winner. And we'll explain how that works in just a little bit. And then a Judges Award winner. I'll start with the Judges Award because, well, Lisa's the judge. And tell us why you liked this particular picture. It's by Gabriel Asaf. And
well,
it's Morgan.
Honestly, the amount of effort that goes into hiring a model, getting a stylist and a makeup artist, it's such a beautiful shot, natural light, great. I've been following this girl for quite a while, and she's really an inspiration to anyone who wants to start to get into fashion photography, and someone that's used Model Mayhem to find models, and now I think she's using models from actual modeling agencies. And I know how difficult it is to approach a stylist and a makeup artist and to organize a shoot and to come up with a theme, and I just think this is such a beautiful springtime portrait fashion shot.
Yeah, I love the color too. It's very muted colors, but that brings out the features, and you focus less on the color and more on her beautiful face. Yeah, that's a great picture. So that's $100 Amazon certificate to Gabriel Asaf. Get yourself a couple of 16 gig high speed cards, or one of those FireWire 800 readers that Thomas was talking about. It really does make a difference, I have to say. And this is our People's Choice Award, Fireworks Friday. Another shot of wishes from Paul Gowder. I like this. I like this a lot.
Yeah, it's difficult. So many people take firework photos, and
this looks like a publicity still. This is amazing.
Yeah.
Wow. And the color, again, beautiful. So both of you win a $100 Amazon gift certificate, compliments of Ford, and the all-new 100% reinvented Ford Explorer. Thank you, Ford. I'm thrilled that we can do this because it gives you a chance to take more pictures and perhaps get some recognition on the air, which is probably in some ways worth more than the gift certificate, but I'm sure both are appreciated. Here's how it works. We're going to give two awards every week, but each week we'll select three finalists. I'm about to show you the finalists from this week. So here's what you should do is take a picture, submit your best picture to the Mostly Photo group on Flickr. That's Mostly, no space, photo on Flickr. And if you're not already a member of the group, it's easy. It's free. If you're not on Flickr, it's easy. It's free. Just go to flickr.com and then go to the groups. Once you sign up, go to the groups tab and search for Mostly Photo, one word. You'll know you're in the right spot when you see thousands of pictures and thousands of members. And you know, it's fun. I think we can do what you were talking about, Thomas, here, and use this as a way to comment on shots as well. I mean, this is a chance for us to do our own critiquing, and everybody will be absolutely very nice in here.
Yeah. This is the nice critique group.
The nice critique, exactly. Yeah. So we're ready for our week two finalists, and again, mostlyphotoadventures.com to see these. These are the three finalists now that Lisa's picked. Winners will be announced on our next episode. Vote now through May 1st. Here's how you vote. Go on Twitter and use the unique Twitter hashtag under your favorite photo. Makes it very easy for us to count. We've got Joshua Gunther. Beautiful cityscape there. That's hashtag Mostly Photo Award 4, all one word. Andre Faubert's picture. I wonder if he used an iPhone tool that we picked on Mac Break Weekly
Tiny World.
I think he did, didn't he?
It's very cool. It's a technique I've yet to try, but I'm really fascinated by it. Canadian.
Is it? What's it called? Tiny World?
Well, that's the technique.
Or Tiny Whirl. Oh, I see. It's
World.
A technique. Yeah. There's an app on the iPad, I think, that does this. I know we picked it on iPad today. So that's cool. But I guess you could do it yourself, Lisa, with Photoshop?
Yeah. I really want to try this out. So it's something
It's
great
cool.
Color. Both
isn't
those.
It? And there's the Joshua Gunter. Boy, that's obviously an HDR and just gorgeous. What city is that? You should know. You've been to the 100 biggest cities in the...
Yeah, you know, I can't tell. It doesn't look familiar to
Houston,
me.
Houston, maybe?
Maybe.
Oh, maybe Austin? I don't know. Because of the lake? I don't know. Probably says if I look. And then this from C. Vicchio, Oh, talk about simple. Beautiful.
Yeah, silhouettes are great.
Yeah, kind of a lone pine. Some very different styles here. This is actually a great trio of pictures you picked, Lisa, because it just shows three very different ways to do pictures. I love that. So if you go to mostlyphotoadventures.com/finalists, you'll see the Twitter hashtags. Everybody tweet now. I'm gonna hold off because I don't want to bias anybody with my pick. I'll tell you the truth. I can't pick. Mostly Photo Award 4, 5, and 6. Our next set. We'll announce our winner next week. And put comments on there when you go to the photos on the Flickr group, too, and talk about why you like the photo. You have until May 1st to get your tweet in. We might count them later just to make sure everybody gets a chance before our next Mostly Photo show. And again, thanks to Ford and the great folks at Ford and their 100% reinvented 2011 Ford Explorer, which we love taking on the road for our photo walks. Oh, Lisa's gone off again. She's probably gone out to take some pictures, knowing her. I'll dial her in again. It's that in-room Wi-Fi that kills us every time. Very, very cool choices. I won't put you on the spot, Thomas. We do want to mention, of course, the 2011 Ford Explorer. In fact, let's do this now while I try to get Lisa back on. And then we have some Q&A for Thomas and Lisa.
I rented one of those Ford Explorers when I was in Dallas and Fort Worth.
Really? Why?
The car at the counter, they asked me if I wanted a Ford Explorer instead of the regular car I'd done.
Yeah.
Well, we had, we were moving around, I think, six photographers. And so it was perfect because we crammed everybody into the thing and we're back and forth between Dallas and Fort Worth, which is a nice drive, a few times, and got everybody in the thing, and it drove great. I liked it.
I'm told that's Los Angeles, by the way.
What's Los Angeles?
That picture. Not your story, the picture. I'm going back in time.
Yeah.
Chat room got me that information.
Yeah.
Citibank is the Citibank Tower building in Los Angeles. That's how they figured it out. Yeah. No, these Explorers are great. If you've got three rows of seating for up to seven people, so you can easily get those six photographers in, plus a lot of gear. In fact, if you have even more gear, the second and third rows fold flat to give you 80.7 cubic feet of space. That's a lot. And of course, that 3.5 liter V6 engine is enough for a lot of fat photographers. 290 horsepower and 255 foot-pound of torque. Towing capacity of up to 5,000 pounds with the optional towing package. So you can haul a boat, camper, or trailer, or just a darkroom behind you.
Or a Hasselblad.
Or a Hasselblad. Big enough for Ansel Adams and all his slide to film. What do they call those? Those glass plates.
Yeah.
And with 25 highway miles per gallon, that's best in class from the EPA. That's pretty impressive. Don't forget, of course, we love the My Ford. Did yours have My Ford Touch built into it?
I don't remember that, no.
Oh, you would. It's got an 8-inch screen in the center, then two little screens behind the steering wheel. And so you control the climate, you control everything in the car, all your music, make phone calls by voice and touch, and it's just so sweet. It is. Oh.
I just remember that my friend Troy Holden got mad at me because all I did was play the country music all week long. It was in Texas.
We had that same problem when we drove the Ford Explorer around Las Vegas. One of our staff members, who shall remain nameless, is not a fan of country music. I happen to like it.
I like it too.
Yeah, especially if you're in Texas.
Right, right.
Thanks to Ford and the 2011 Ford Explorer for bringing us the Mostly Photo Adventure Awards. Okay, Lisa's back.